Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel for I guess what I would call another segment of Dark Fun in the Dark Sun. Today, instead of talking about the story, we're going to talk a little bit more about the characters because with a whopping 18 characters between the six players, it can get a little hectic and it can get a little crazy. So I just kind of want to have one place where everyone could go if they want to know a little bit more about the characters. So these characters are from three different campaigns. So the first one is Welcome to the Dark Sun, which was our entry into Athas. And so I have already done a pretty in-depth video about those characters, which I'll link right here. But I will still give the basics because I want to kind of lay it out as this player is playing these characters, just so they kind of mesh together more, I think. The second campaign that the characters come from is part of the Dark Fun in the Dark Sun campaign in total, but it's from the Freedom campaign, which we wrapped up a couple weeks ago. And then the third set of characters is also from Dark Fun in the Dark Sun, but from the Road to Uruk campaign, which we just started a couple weeks ago. You might be a little bit more familiar with who they are because as we just started the campaign, I just introduced all the characters, but I figured let's get like player one plays these characters, player two plays these characters, etc. I'm not naming names of the players because they do value their privacy and all that jazz, so it's just gonna be player one, player two, player three, player four, but that way you'll know which characters are played by the same person. So with that, let's just get into it. So first of all, we have player one. So player one plays Salentithius, Raylan, and Sage. Salentithius is from Welcome to the Dark Sun. He's a Thrycreen, he is a rogue, he is an arcane trickster, and he is an accidental folk hero. And while I wouldn't say he was one of the more important characters in Welcome to the Dark Sun, as things have shifted in Dark Fun in the Dark Sun to more diplomacy and all that, he's actually become very integral because he gets along really well with King Tithian somehow. Don't know how it worked, it's like one of those friendships you would never expect. But he's super good at being rational and just kind of trying to get everything moving. The next character played by player one is Raylan. She's an elf and a druid from the Circle of the Shepherd, which is from Xanathar's Guide, and her background is Outlander. She started in the Freedom campaign, she started as a slave, and her claim to fame thus far has been convincing Nebuchadnezzar that he wants to fight with the Tyrian army to protect the city. She's also a pretty good and pretty heavy spellcaster. In fact, she only carries one weapon, which is a metal dagger, that I don't think she's ever used. And the final character for this player is Sage. She is from the Road to Uruk campaign, which is the one that we just started on, so she was created at the beginning of this. She's a monk, and her monastic tradition is the Way of the Sun Soul, which is also from Xanathar's Guide, and her background is a hermit. Basically, she came from not in the city, she ended up in the city, and seems like it's gonna be a good time to eat a lot of people. Next up is player two. Player two plays Vashti, Kadan, and Regal. So Vashti is from Welcome to the Dark Sun. She is a half-elf and a former slave. And she's a bard from the College of Lore, and she just likes killing things. Like, that's her MO, is kill as many things as you can, especially if you can get away with it. Which actually is really funny, because in this campaign, she was recently deputized as a Templar, so now she's, like, sanctioned killing, basically. Not that it stopped her before, but at least she's got someone to back her up now. Next up is Kadan, who is from the Freedom campaign. He is a dwarf and a cleric of the Grave Domain, and his background is also Outlander. And Kadan was actually, like, the great gladiator who ended up piercing Kallak with the Heartwood Sphere at the end of the Freedom campaign. So, pretty boss. And kind of an important figure in the post-Kallak regime. And because he's a dwarf on Athas, he does have a focus, and his focus is to found and build his own town. And I hope that he will get the chance to do that at some point. The final character for this player is Regal, who, if you remember from the Freedom campaign right at the very end, he was an NPC named Urgos. And Urgos and Little Jenny, who we will get into in a minute, became nobles of the House Sten, and one of the brothers who had just been murdered was named Regal, and so Urgos was like, I'm Regal. And so Urgos has become Regal, this noble, and has basically just tried to slot himself into that guy's life, including trying to convince Henron, who was Regal's actual son, that he is his son. It hasn't been working so well. But Urgos is a half-giant. He took 5 levels of barbarian and 3 levels of rogue. For Barbarian, he took the Berserker archetype, and for Rogue, he took the Scout. and he is of noble background, which I think is something he adopted once he became a noble. He's probably one of the funniest characters that we have at the table too. It's quite enjoyable to have Regal around. Next, we have Player 3, and Player 3 plays Dono the Iron Rider, Eighth Wonder Large Sun, and Dusky Court. So Dono the Iron Rider was from Welcome to the Dark Sun, and right at the end of that campaign, he actually defeated the Iron Rider, who was the one who decimated the entire clan of Arigato, which is Dono's clan. And so Dono took the helmet, although I'm pretty sure Salentithia is like thrust on his head, and now he's taken up the mantle of the Iron Rider, which is pretty cool. And he is an elf, and he is a ranger. And he got really good at ranged attacks because he added a bunch of feats and other things into that skill, and he can now hit something from about 600 feet away, which is ridiculous. Eighth Wonder Largeson is the youngest Largeson brother. We'll get into that in a minute, but we have a lot of Largesons on our party. And he is a half giant, and he is a bard, which you might not think makes a lot of sense because he's a half giant, but really it's because he was the youngest and his mommy babied him the most and pushed him to be creative and get into the arts, and so that's why he became a bard. And his favorite instrument is the drums, specifically when they're like skulls. He likes to pound on skulls. It makes him happy. Out of the Largeson brothers, he's definitely the most picked on as well, and it's probably because his mommy loved him so much. So Eighth Wonder was from the Freedom campaign, and the final character for this player is from the Road to Uruk, and it is Dusky Court. Dusky Court is a dwarf, he's a rogue from the Mastermind archetype, and his background is urchin. And this player hasn't actually been around a lot for this campaign, so I don't really have a feel for him yet, but he seems like a gruff, rough and tumble type of dwarf, and I think it'll be a lot of fun as we get to know him more. Player number 4 also has 3 characters. First is Nibbles, second is Little Jenny, and third is Kill Big Largeson. I mean, technically his full name is Kill Big or Go Home Largeson, but you get the point. So Nibbles is from Welcome to the Dark Sun. She is a halfling monk from the Way of the Four Elements. And basically, during the entire Welcome to the Dark Sun campaign, she would just go in and just destroy people with her fists. It was pretty amazing. She's also a very cultured halfling because she had family in the forest, but she lived in the city and was used to the ways of the city folk. But you did not want to get in her way, especially when she was spending key points like crazy to put you down. The next character for player 4 is also a halfling. This halfling is from the Freedom campaign and her name is Little Jenny. She's a bard of the College of Swords and her background is entertainer. And Little Jenny, despite being small, liked to insert herself into situations, so she actually got really close with the rebel leaders within the slave pits. But then, because of things that happened, she ended up getting booted out of the slave pits and she became a noble. So she's like the other noble brother of the House Den. There's her and Regal. And the final character is from the Road to Uruk campaign, and this is Kill Big or Go Home Largeson, another one of the Largeson brothers. He's actually also Lord Jackhammer's twin brother, so they're like the second youngest Largesons, I think? Anyway, he is a half-giant and a barbarian on the Zealot path. And his background is a sailor, but in all reality, he was trying to sign up to be a soldier. Got confused and ended up on a silt skimmer for a little while before he ended up back in the city of Tyr because he like got off the boat to take a leak and then the silt skimmer disappeared without him. That's about how our Largeson do. Next is player 5, who obviously also has 3 characters. The first character is Drudok. Then we have Halvar Largeson, who's another Largeson brother, and Nigila. So Drudok was from Welcome to the Dark Sun, and as a Thrykreen, he and Salentithias were actually pretty close. He was a bard from the College of Whispers, and he was the type of character who would just think his way out of everything. Instead of like just beating something up or using spells, it was always being super analytical of the situation to see what he could do to make it work in the most hilarious and random ways possible. My favorite example of this probably was when we found an agony beetle and we stuffed it in a glass vial, and then later he took the glass vial, stuffed it in someone's mouth, and punched them in the face, so they end up ingesting the agony beetle. It was pretty awesome. Next up is Halvar Largeson. He is from the Freedom campaign. He is a half-giant, a ranger, and a folk hero, and he is actually the eldest of the Largeson brothers. So he tries to wrangle everyone together, and it honestly doesn't work very often. But he is probably the biggest proponent of Skyrocks, which were a huge thing in the Larson family. Basically, it's the brothers throwing rocks into the sky so they hit their other brothers and just being like, wow, look at that sky rock. And because they're all kind of stupid, they all kind of believe it. The final character for player 5 is Najila. She is an elf and a scion of the Wujin mystic school, and her background is hermit. And despite the fact that we've only had her around for a few sessions, she is super effective. Scions are crazy good, and honestly, if I were to roll up another character, I would definitely have to consider scions and their crazy brain powers. And there's actually some pretty good playtest material out there for it, so like, there's legit stuff, we didn't have to convert it. So I mean, that's a win. And last but not least is player number 6, and player number 6 has 3 characters as well. Kind of. But we'll get to that in a second. So the characters are Bardock, Yuri, Lord Jackhammer Largeson, another Largeson brother, and Twin to Killbig, and Shoji. So let's talk about Bardock a little bit first, because Bardock isn't actually playing anymore. So Bardock was from the Welcome to the Dark Sun campaign. He is a Mull Druid from the Circle of the Land, and he was a former slave, but he'd been treated pretty well because he was a Mull. He was super old too, like on his last legs during the campaign, and when Kallak fell, Bardock was not happy about this, because Bardock did not understand that Kallak was a defiler. He thought he was a good wizard, and so he was pretty choked that everybody had ganged up and killed him, so Bardock just took his giant scorpion Stingy, and they pieced out of the city together, like off, you know, walking into the sunset kind of situation. I doubt we'll ever see him again. Either Stingy probably stung him or he just dropped dead. But Bardock was quite the character. If you go back to the Welcome to the Dark Sun playlist, you can see that him and his big mouth got us into trouble so often. So next we're gonna go to Yuri, Lord Jackhammer Largeson. He mostly just goes by Lord Jackhammer. I think most people have forgot that he does have a first name. But he is a half-giant berserker barbarian with an entertainer's background. Because basically his goal is to be the greatest wrestler ever. Like, he's like WWE level, I wanna fight. He's also still looking to hire someone just to oil up his body all the time, so he really looks the part. But despite all that, he ended up being super effective in the Freedom campaign because he ended up on that managerial path, and he did a very good job of that and of seizing the means of production and all the resources within the slave pit. And since slaves have been freed, he's come out, he's become a councilman representing the dispossessed, and he's actually done a lot of good in council, which you wouldn't really expect from a half-giant named Lord Jackhammer. And finally you have Shoji, and Shoji is a human, which is crazy because out of all those 18 characters, Shoji is the only human. He used to be a Templar, but he lost all his spells and everything when Kallak fell. But a couple sessions ago we actually found a magic ring that you can store spells in, so we've given that to him, so at least he has a couple. But he is a fighter on the samurai path, and his background is City Watch. And the great thing about Shoji is because he was a Templar before, he definitely has a lot of connections with Templar, and that just helps us navigate some of the laws occasionally. Okay, and now just in case you're still confused, I'm just going to group all the characters together based on who plays them. So player 1 plays Salentithius, Raylan, and Sage. Player 2 plays Vashti, Kadan, and Regal. Player 3 plays Dono, Eighth Wonder, and Dusky. Player 4 plays Nibbles, Little Jenny, and Killbig. Player 5 plays Drudok, Halvar, and Najila. And player 6 plays Lord Jackhammer and Shoji because Bardock is long gone into the sunset. Alrighty, so I hope that cleared up some of the confusion with the character tree that we have in like the 17 playable characters plus Bardock. I know it wasn't super in-depth, but at least it's something to try to lay everything out. It's getting super complicated with all these players. Of course, as always, if you have any questions or comments, make sure to leave them down below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And with that, thanks for watching.